Hi everyone, this is Dr. Nishtha Jain from Air Cruise Aviation, and today we'll be talking about air hostess cabin crew jobs, the eligibility criteria, the requirements, the qualifications, and every such thing, everything in detail. Okay, so now let's see it one by one. First of all, what is an air hostess? Actually, air hostess is a person who will be assisting the passengers in the flight, right? Flight attendants are also known as air hostess or cabin crews. All right. Now, the flight attendants, what is their work? Their work is to ensure the safety, right? And the comfort of passengers. And many, you know, high school graduates are looking for such jobs, for such cabin crew jobs. Okay. So now, see, this is a cabin crew. You can see it, right? This is the cabin crew. People usually don't understand cabin crew. They just know about air hostess. It's not that. It's actually a cabin crew. There are many jobs in airlines which you should be aware of. The eligibility criteria which is required, which is mandatory for this job, is a 10 plus 2 pass certificate, right? Or a graduation degree. And that graduation degree should be preferably in hotel management or tourism, right? And the age limit is below 25 years of age. Yes, that is the age limit. And the height requirement is 154.5 centimeter to 157.5 centimeter tall. So it's roughly around 5 feet 1 inch approximately. Okay. So sorry. Yeah, some degrees which are preferable for this career are BSc in Aviation, BBA in Travel Management, BSc in Airline. Okay. Now, see, these are the air hostesses, flight attendants. We all know this. Okay. Now, these are the photo guidelines. These are the photo guidelines. These are very, very important. And you should be aware of these. Okay. So what exactly is required in a proper photograph which is to be pasted or which is to be sent for this job? So the professional grooming tips are very important, like a visible proper makeup, your hair tied properly and neatly in a bun. And, you know, must have a natural happy smile. A positive attitude should be visible on your face. And a full length, the top of your head and your shoes must be visible, right? That means, see, this picture here, this is a full length photo. You have to give such a photo, such a similar photo in such a similar dress. Okay. And hands straight by side with both legs straight together. Stand up straight. You can see that in the picture. Okay. You must be directly facing the camera. Yes. Okay. There should be a good lighting. Sharp and in focus and a very clear picture. Okay. This should be the full photo. And the passport size photo must be quite similar to the full photo face. Yes, there should be not much difference in the photos of the same person. And a business attire should be chosen for the photos, like a close-fitted jacket, knee-length skirt, high heels, right? Skin color stockings. These are a must. These are very important. Please keep this in mind. Okay, no neck scarves or no jewelry. You're not allowed for any jewelry, any neck scarves, any fashion, any style. These things are not allowed. Okay, no glasses, no color contact lenses. This is also very important. You're not allowed to wear glasses, right? Or any colored contact lens. You have to be very natural in this. And no watches. So no accessories in short. Okay, no jewelry, no accessories, nothing like that. Right? Okay. Now, see, these are the pictures in which way you have to dress up, right? Like you can see the girl there, her hair are neatly tied up, right? In a bun. Then she has a good full makeup on her face. She's in a business attire, right? And her shoes, her heels. You have to wear heels. This is for females and for males. How is it to be done? The hair should be neatly presented. Properly combed and presented. Face should be clean shaven. You have to be clean shaved for that. The dress code is suit or a smart business attire. Yes, a single breasted suit has to be chosen for this. Okay, and formal work shoes. Yes, these are the things you have to keep in mind, especially for sending the photographs also. Okay. Now, so working as a cabin crew is, of course, and a very inspiring choice. Yes, it inspires a lot of people indeed. Yes, many people are interested in this job. Okay, the interview dress code. This is the dress code you have to follow for interviews, right? Okay, you have to avoid clean shaven or beard closely trimmed, right? Closely trimmed beard, you have to avoid clean shaven look or avoid an aftershave, right? White or light colored shirt. You can see it. There's a white shirt, yeah, beneath the blue blazer or blue suit, okay? An unobtrusive tie, a tailored single breasted suit, as I told you previously, a belt, dark plain socks, and black leather shoes. These are the male attire. Okay, and for the females, these have to be neat and tidy hairstyle, tied in a bun, neatly packed. Okay, soft, subtle, and unfussy makeup. Yes, the makeup should not be fussy or, you know, a very rough makeup or an inappropriate makeup. You have to keep that in mind. It should be a very soft and a subtle makeup, not very glowy or maybe you can very heavy makeup. You don't have to do that. A very soft and normal makeup. Don't show much flesh, cleavage, or leg. Yes, you don't have to show much of your skin, in short. Okay, long sleeved shirt, plain blouse, jacket, or blazer. Yes, a long sleeve shirt has to be there and a plain blouse or a plain jacket. Okay. Now, avoid too much of jewelry. You're not allowed to wear jewelry as such. Accessories and jewelry, as I told you in the previous slide, you're not allowed for the jewelry and the accessories. Okay. Smart mid-length skirt or dress. Yes. You can see the dress in the picture. It has to be of this length. An ankle-length skirt, as we saw previously, right? Dark or natural colored tights or stockings, you can say, and dark low-heeled shoes. All right, these things have to be kept in mind. Yeah, you have to remember these very clearly. Okay, now you can earn extra points for glasses, corporate colors, fresh breathe, and polished shoes. Yes, you can earn extra points for these. Okay. And where are you more prone to lose points? If you have any body piercings, any stains on your clothes, or if you're wearing sports shoes instead of, you know, formal shoes, or if you are smelling bad, or maybe you are not smelling good, you can say that. And if you have any tattoos which are being displayed, which are visible, then you are going to lose some points for these. You have to keep these in also in your mind. Okay, now the institutes which are offering this course is Asiatic International Aviation Academy. Yes, they are offering the training to join such jobs. The personality traits which are required, you have to have an attractive personality, a pleasant personality, a pleasant appearance, a physical stamina to work in adverse conditions. Yes. The timings which are allotted are quite different. You can, you know, every month, your roster changes every month. So you should have a physical stamina also to work in any kind of condition. Yeah. And a friendly personality. If you have a friendly personality, a pleasant personality, a smiling face. Okay. See, these are the way in which the air hostesses assist the passengers. Right. Okay. You should have a friendly manner. Yes, you have to be very friendly with the passengers. You don't have to, you know, show a lot of attitude or arrogance, or you don't have to ignore their requests or suggestions. You have to be very open to these. Okay, and a smiling face is, of course, very necessary for almost any job, right? Okay, now the job profile. What exactly is to be done after, you know, becoming an air hostess or a cabin crew? Welcoming of passengers. I'm sorry for the stammering. Welcoming of passengers, Yes, the air hostesses firstly welcome the passengers when they are boarding the flight, right? Then they introduce safety procedures. Yeah, they make them aware of all the safety procedures, and they provide them food and drinks, and they attend passengers during critical or adverse conditions, especially when the flights are facing some rough weather conditions, right? Turbulence and all. Okay. So, yes. Then doing meditation is something you have to teach the passengers, especially in tough conditions. Yeah. Okay. Then helping them in maybe, you know, stuffing their luggage or in whichever way they want, right? Okay. And the remuneration which you are offered is it is paid according to your experience. So for the freshers, it may be between 16,000 to 30,000. Yes, and reputed international airlines pay an average of nearly 1.5 lakh rupees, with senior air hostesses getting above 3 lakhs. Yeah, so as much as you have your experience, the more you will be paid. Very simple. Okay. Now, the job category, the salaries for different job categories are: for a flight attendant, the annual salary is 4,80,000 to 6,75,000. For senior air hostess, it is rupees 5,50,000 to 8,25,000. These are the approximate salaries I'm telling you. For a ground attendant, it is 5,04,000 to 7,35,000. For a cabin crew, it is 5,04,000 to 7,02,000. And for a customer service agent, it is 3,60,000 to 4,32,000. These are the rough figures in which you'll be getting your salary. Okay, now the suitability. There are a few parameters on which you are judged for the job. Yeah, so these are very important in you. You have to have such qualities, you can say. Yeah, so the first one is a technical knowledge. A basic technical knowledge is a must. Then good maturity, good adaptability. You have to be adaptable to different situations, to different conditions. Right, then a good judgment as to, you know, you should understand if there is a problem, you should you know, quickly understand the solution for it and provide the same. Right, you should be good at grooming, you should be well groomed. Okay, you should have a positive and a good attitude. Right, you should feel happy, you have to be friendly with the passengers, as I've told previously. And then you have to be empathic. That means you have to understand the problems of the passengers also. You have to feel it for them to understand it clearly. Okay, you have to be sincere and dedicated. You have to be a good listener and a good communicator. You have to listen to the problem first and then communicate and all, and then respond. Okay, and you should have good patience and knowledge about everything related to the flight. Right? Other than that, you should have leadership qualities, a team spirit. You should be a quick decision taker, as I've told previously. You should be composed and attentive. You don't have to get angry on the passengers, right? If they're requesting for something, if they're asking for some help, you have to remain composed and calm and then help them, right? And you have to act like a guide to the customers, okay? Okay. So some of the top airline recruiting companies, which are these companies? These are very famous companies. You might have heard of them. Air India, then Air India Express, Air India, Air Asia, Indigo, Vistara, right? SpiceJet. These are the top airline recruiting companies. Okay, then the types of airline jobs. Which are the types of jobs which are available in airline? The first one is ground station attendant, right? Second one is passenger service agent, sales representative, crew schedule coordinator, okay, ramp planner, reservation sales manager. Okay, these are a few jobs which you can apply for. And now, this is a very important one, a resume. Yeah, nowadays, they're asking for resumes because of this lockdown, the corona thing. Yes. So you have to be very good with the resume. It's a video resume. Yeah, the short word is resume. So this Air Cruise Aviation is going to help you with that if you need any kind of guidance or any kind of help. Yeah, we'll be happy to help you for this. Okay, now The admissions are open for commercial pilot training at aircruiseaviation.com. This is the number. You can note it down. You can save it in your phone, and you can WhatsApp on this number for any further guidance or any further queries, right? Okay, now the main disadvantages of being a flight attendant. There are, of course, a positive and negative aspects to everything. So here are a few negative points which you have to adjust with, right? The first one is your work schedule roster is never the same. As I have mentioned in the previous slides also, if you're a person who loves changes, then it's fine for you. But then your roster is never the same. Sometimes you may have a night shift, sometimes you may have a day shift. It all depends on the roster which you are provided. Yeah, you get a new roster every month. So depending on your roster, you will either have a great month or a bad month. Okay. Now, lack of sleep, of course, because of inappropriate timings or because of timings which are not suitable to us, of course, our sleep patterns get disturbed. So yes, your sleep patterns will all be messed up, and you have no other choice than to sleep forcefully. Yes, whenever you get time, you have to sleep at that time. You cannot help with it. Okay, because you have to recharge your batteries, right, for the next shift. Okay. Now, relationships, even if you're surrounded by, you know, many people around you, still you feel alone at times. You cannot always share your feelings or, you know, your happiness or sadness with the crew members. You always need someone else to share it with, someone who's close to you. But that also gets affected here. Okay. Okay, so these are the online ground classes for pilots. Yes, these are being conducted by the Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. You can clear DGCA exams for navigation, meteorology, regulations for PPL and CPL. Yes. Okay. Now, online career counseling for airline pilot training is by Captain Shekhar Gupta. Yes. And he has also written a great book, which is Pilot Career Guide. Yes, you must go through it. You must read it to understand more about the pilot training. And online career counseling for AME, Aerospace Engineering, Aircraft Maintenance Engineering by Mandir Kaur. Yes, she's an aerospace engineer and she'll be helping with the online career counseling for aerospace engineering and aircraft maintenance engineering. Alpha Airline Training, online and offline classes are available in Delhi or Mumbai. And of course, for these classes, for more information, you can contact on any of these numbers. Yeah, these are from airaviator.com. This is the website for more details. Okay. Now, yes, the commercial pilots program. This is being conducted by Captain Shweta Borikar. Yes. And in association with, of course, Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. Yeah. These are the WhatsApp number. You can use these numbers to, you know, get more details on anything you want. Or this is the website for any other detail or any other query or any other required information. Yeah. Okay. Online free flight training for students who want to be a pilot. Yes, this is also being done by Captain Shweta Borikar. She's a pilot in USA. Okay. Okay, and yes, you will be getting trained and coached by industry veterans, by industry experts who have been experts in this domain, right? So that's a very good opportunity. You must go for it. And Captain Shekhar Gupta's book. Yes, this is available on Amazon. So you can order it as soon as possible and you can go through the book. You can understand more about how to become an international airline pilot. So let me tell you something about Captain Shekhar Gupta. He's a professional pilot with more than 8 years of experience of flying on 14 different types of aircraft. And that too in 10 different countries. Yes, so you must go through the book. It's a wonderful book and it will definitely help you with becoming an airline pilot, an international airline pilot. Thank you so much for your time. I hope I have been able to help